Hello, coloring friends. Welcome to another color along out of seasons as I attempt to finish this book this year. And so for this page, I will be doing my usual mediums of Neocolor 2 for the background and Prismacolor for the pencil work. So I'm starting off with filling in the background with my Neo 2s, and I do two layers of Neo 2 for the two darkest colors. For some reason, that brown just doesn't want to be as dark as I would like it to be. And then after the Neo colors dry later on, I also do some additional shading in those darkest areas. So I just continue on here to lay down those Neo 2 colors. And if you might be interested in a video that I had just recently put out on my channel talking about how I like to use Neocolor 2s for background, and I also discuss a little bit of types of paper that is best suited for using Neocolor 2s, and in my opinion. So I will put a link to that video down below if you're interested. Otherwise, this video will be on silent as usual, and I will be popping in and out explaining what I'm doing through voiceovers as I go along. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, and enjoy the video. All right, and so here I am activating those Neo2s and blending them out with a regular watercolor paintbrush in round size 10. And just kind of going back and forth between those transition areas to achieve a nice little transition from the lightest to the darkest colors. And once I get into some of the tighter places, I will move on to my water brush pen. And so here's where I start adding in that second layer to darken up the Neo2s that are around the frame there that Hannah had drawn in. And I'm just pulling colors straight from the Neo2 crayon and dabbing it in to those areas where I want it more saturated with color. All right, and so here I've grabbed my Coliro Pearlocolors. They are a metallic watercolor palette, and I'm using the bronze metallic watercolor from this palette to just dab in some bronze accents. All right, and so as I finish up with my Neocolor 2 activating here, I just wanted to mention that lately I have been going back once the Neocolor 2s are fully dry. I have been ironing my pages, especially if I have to color skin. Because the paper does get a little bit warped, especially if I have to color skin afterwards, then I do like that paper to lay a little bit more flat. And if you have any questions about ironing your pages, if you've never done that before, just let me know in the comment section and I'll be happy to explain. Okay, so I am starting here coloring her skin, and I am starting off with a super light layer of light peach all over. So remember to make your layers very light when doing skin. That way you can put on many layers before the tooth of the paper is full and won't take any more. Okay, now moving on to seashell pink, I'm going to start kind of mapping out where all of the shadows and shading will be. So here I've pulled out my kneaded eraser. I started using this just recently for portraits, and I find it works just a little bit better for just removing that top layer of pencil. If maybe you got somewhere, maybe it didn't look quite as good as you wanted it to, and you just want to erase that top layer of pencil, a kneaded eraser is really handy. So I'll put a link to those down in the description box below. So here's where I've started blending out the colors, and I alternate between kind of beige and white as I work my way across her skin and laying down white in the highlight areas that I want to stay bright, and then going lightly over those highlight areas with that beige. And so here I felt like her chin needed a little bit more color. And so I'm filling in some of that white space that I had there with peach and light peach. Okay, and so now just very lightly going in with that dark brown and adding a little bit more depth to some of those shadow areas. And then I kind of blend it out just lightly with light peach. And so, yes, I finally remembered her ears. You guys are probably thinking, oh my gosh, you're not doing her ears. Yeah, I totally forgot until afterwards. And I'm like, wait a minute, something looks off here. Okay, and so I'm kind of leaving the very tops of her iris uncolored because I'm just going to go over that with black a little bit later on anyway. Okay, and just to make the image look a little bit more realistic, I felt like it looked kind of weird because she didn't have a waterline on her eyes. So I just kind of drew one in with black and kind of just tried to smudge the area around it so it looked like makeup. And so here I'm using that light peach just to blend out the outer bits of the black eyeliner that I put on her. Okay, so here I've grabbed my Faber-Castell Pitt pen, and I'm using it to draw in some kind of sheer transparent shine lines on her eyes, and then I'll go back in with my white Posca and add a little bit more of the white shine to her eyes, and I just kind of fiddle around with it until it looks right. If I get it wrong, I'll use my Prisma colorless blender to kind of scratch off any areas and fine-tune it a little bit. Okay, so for the eyebrows, I always like to just draw some little tiny hair lines right at the top of the eyebrows that Hannah has drawn in, and that just kind of softens up those harsh lines that she has in for eyebrows. All right, and so a lot of the times I will outline my metal work in black or like espresso. It just helps that metal work pop. And so on this page, I will be outlining all of the metal work in black. And so here I am going back in with that dark brown, just ever so lightly, to add in a little bit more shading. I feel I can always tweak and tweak and tweak and add more and more to the face, and at some point I have to just say, okay, no more. But I did really feel like it just needed a little bit more dark brown in some areas here. All right, so I just want to make a little note here. So I had left just the tiniest little space between where I apply the black raspberry and the line that Hannah had drawn in for her lips, thinking that I would put some kind of highlight there. And I do, I put in light peach in there, and then I actually didn't like it. So later on, I do end up bringing that black raspberry all the way to the line that Hannah had drawn in. So if you want to go ahead and do that, that's fine. I just wanted to let you know and save you some work. If you want to just kind of skip ahead and see what I did before you actually start laying down your color. And so here I bring in that pale vermilion pencil and just lightly go over the white lines for highlights that I drew in for her lips, just to kind of tone those down a little bit. All right, so here I've grabbed some acrylic paint in a metallic copper, and I shook it up really good, and so there was some on the inside of the cap, which I just went ahead and used as my palette. And I'm taking my dot tool and just going over those dots that Hannah had drawn in with that acrylic paint. If you don't have like a copper acrylic paint, you could always use a gold acrylic paint. That would look nice as well. Or a gel pen, that would work nice also. So with this gold shimmer spray, I am just taking off the cap and dropping it onto the paper from the nozzle that way, just because this nozzle doesn't have a very good spray pump, and it just kind of gets over and it's not very controlled. So I kind of wanted it to look more like drops on the paper. And you can see I do get like one big drop that I do end up cleaning off. But yeah, the drop method just seems to work a little bit better for me. All right, and so this completes this video. I hope you've enjoyed it, and if you have any questions or comments, leave them down below. Please hit the like button if you haven't already, and feel free to subscribe if you would like to see more of this type of content. Take care, everyone. See you next time.